morning, everyone. I am currently on my stationary bike. It has wheels in the front, and it's very light, considering how heavy it could be. But I just hold it from the back, and I roll it right up to the steps, and then I lift it up over the steps, and then roll it from the steps into the house. My son's room has a lot of room in it because I just changed his bed from a queen to a full, no, to a twin. So I may leave it in his room right here behind me, or I may put it on the porch just so that the children don't play on it. But either way, I will be able to exercise while the baby's right there in the other room. She's a little bit further down the hallway. Hopefully, I don't think it's loud enough to wake her up, but she's in my bed. I'm going to set my alarm for an hour, so hopefully I can get an hour of biking in. I'm still not where I was Monday on my weight. I just weighed myself. I got a couple more ounces to go down. I should be getting my vitamins in today, my supplements, and so I'm really excited to go ahead and get this hour knocked out. I'm right next to the bar, so I have somewhere to put my phone at. It's easy reachable. Let me show y'all. I got this water bottle for my husband from Walmart. It's Conigo Fit. It's very, very nice. Let's see if I can show you this. So, it's got this lock right here. And then it opens when you press it. 64 ounces, so it's half a gallon. And then when you don't want it to just randomly pop open like this, you just lock it back. That's a safety lock. It has some electrolyte drink in it, like Mio, but it's like a Walmart brand. But my husband forgot it on the counter. This is his. He needs to drink more water because he'll go to the store and he'll get Coke instead of water. But if he has water accessible to him at work, he will drink it. But it's very, very heavy duty made. I love it. And so I'll be drinking this today because he forgot it on the counter. But I think it's awesome. It's got its lock and everything. I think it's so cool. $14 at Walmart in the by the camping section where they have the water bottles for the workout gear. There isn't a whole lot of workout gear at my Walmart, but this was there. You can hear my air fryer is going crazy over there. I don't know what's wrong with it, but the time and temp changes all the time. So, cooking some pork. But, really like this bottle. Well, she's awake. I got about 20 minutes left on this thing to make an hour, so I'm just gonna hold her. She's heavy. What you making all that noise for, girl? She in your nest? Are those yours? So, I have a lot of Bantam chickens. Most of them are pure Cochin. Bantam Cochin. This is a game bird cross right here. This is, I believe this is Pumpkin. She is so broody. A lot of my Bantams are broody. I thought these were pure Bantam Cochin eggs, and obviously they're not. And this is why I can't hatch like whatever eggs I find out in the yard, because they're not what I thought they were. So that Bantam Cochin is mad because she's in this nest. But they're sharing this nest. They're all the way in the back corner, almost, of the property. There's a quail that I hatched. There's a couple more in there. I lost a bunch of them. I don't know why. Some chicks that I had them with were killing them. And also, just some of them randomly died. This is Feather, a standard Rex. Next to her is Dude. Feather is pregnant. Here is a lion head. She is pedigreed. She is pregnant. Just got her. There's Ruthie. She's a chocolate lion head. She's not pedigreed, but she is pregnant.
Buckles and Tulip are in here because Tulip did not take the last time. This is Madame. She did not take either. Here is Beauty and Benjamin. She did not take. Here's Autumn. She did not take. Here's my new Flemish giant buck. His name is Cash. Here's Truffles. He's in here. He was just moved from Sarah's cage. Here's Boop. I just got Boop. Boop is a broken New Zealand. He was a pet. He was supposed to be a girl. He's not. My friend is going to take him to breed with her meat rabbits, but I will probably use him in the future because I don't have a large meat mixed rabbit. He's not mixed, but I can use him to breed Lily, who is my mixed breed doe. Just come over here and take a look at these rabbits. Here is Flopsy. She still has her babies. These two broken chocolates I am keeping. That little black one back there is the only buck in this cage, and he's available. And then this little broken tort. She's a black tort. She's spoken for. Sarah is pregnant. I didn't think she took, but she actually did. So, that's good. Yano Lily. Here's Lily. She's due in about 5 to 6 days. Juniper's due at the same time. Here's Coco. She is a pedigreed Netherland dwarf. She's not stuck. She just has herself there. She goes, she just wanted to be back there, which her pretty ears. Look how little her short her ears are. This is a great looking Netherland dwarf. She's pedigreed. She's pregnant. She's due this Saturday. 2 days. Here's Talia. Let me show y'all Talia's babies. They're so cute. Got that light on for y'all. Okay, so she's got 3 blue-eyed whites. See their blue eyes? Gorgeous. So there's the blue-eyed whites. There's 1 doe and 2 bucks. This one right here is a buck. And then there's another one that looks like that. And it is a doe. So there's a buck and a doe in that color. The little chocolate right there is a buck. I am going to keep him. And this little one right here is a buck as well. I may keep him as well and bring him back to his mama in hopes that I get more babies that look like him and her. Because she is so pretty. Close this cage real quick before we move on. Here's Mopsy. Mopsy is my chocolate hollandock. This is her buck. It's a little boy. Chocolate buck. I am keeping him to... Sorry, my phone ran out of space. So this is the chocolate buck. I am keeping him to breed with those broken chocolates in Flopsy's cage. And she's got a little black one. Not sure what this one is yet. But since I can tell what this one is, I should be able to tell what this one is very soon. But they're fat and healthy. Y'all can hear the goats back there fighting. They're still, haven't seemed to settle down and get used to each other yet. There's Lolly. Gorgeous Flemish. She is pregnant. These are my Flemish babies that I still have available except for this red-eyed white. My daughter decided to keep this buck right here. And then she decided, well, I kind of talked her into keeping a doe instead of a buck. So, we've got a doe. Here's Bonnie. She's pregnant. And then you see Polly down there. She's pregnant as well. Cute little babies, are y'all hungry? She's coming to feed y'all. She's on the other side of the fence. Yeah, but this is BB, our little red-eyed white Flemish giant. She's coming, ladies. The duck got out of the pen the other day. There's a broody turkey back there. So this is in my new trailer. And if you look back there, Blue has tried to sit on eggs several times, but they were not fertilized, so I've been taking them. But I have seen Tom mate with Jen. I'm hopeful that Tom mated with her as well. He was sick for a little while, but he's doing like really good now. He completely healed up. But Sophia's going to try to attempt to roll these two eggs to her. Turkeys are very aggressive whenever they are on eggs, so she's going to try to not get too close to her. But we want to get these eggs close to her so that they are incubated as well. Because if they're not under her, they're not going to hatch. She's trying not to get bit. Oh, can't see. Just stick your hand down there. She'll be fine. You got it? Yeah, just get them up next to her. She will press them in. There you go. She's mad. I see her puffing up at you. Just get that one closest like you got the other one. And then use it. She's hissing? Well, it's just a warning. She's not going to bite you yet. There you go. Alrighty. Back up. She's going to tuck them in underneath her. There's a chicken laying egg right here, too. One of the white rock chickens has been laying here, but she's not sitting yet.
Yeah, the ducks got up.
No.
The guinea's on the other side of the ditch, yeah. They got out. Okay.
They can swim. Like, mm-hmm. They got over there, then.
It flew across the ditch. It didn't swim. So hopefully she will tuck this these two eggs underneath her, because she's been sitting for 2 days, maybe. I have two broody chickens and a broody duck as well, so. Baby pigs. The female that had the babies recently passed away. I'm not sure why, but I did change their feed to a different feed. Their feed now comes from the same company that I get my rabbit feed from. So I just got them a whole bunch of green, some grass, and some clover. And there's my new guinea pig right there. Let me see if I can show you her face. She is so pretty. She's a chocolate and white. She's so pretty. And then we have the hamsters outside now that it's warming up. It's supposed to drop down to like 27 Saturday, so I don't know how they're gonna do out here, but my husband doesn't live in the house anymore. But they have lots of bedding to bundle up in. Let me see. Why'd you crush it? Feed her a treat. You want a treat? Come get it. She doesn't want it. I'll leave it right there for her.
Will she take it?
It's
too big to fit through there.
Yeah. She'll find it. She's looking for it. Oh, she finally got a piece.
Were you asking if this was the boy?
No.
This is the girl. She's the one that takes the whole thing. You gotta pop it through that wire though. There. Oh, and it's gone. Yeah, look how big her cheeks are. She's been stuffing her mouth full of food.
Normally, they're tiny.
Hamsters like to... She's trying to get that little bitty piece off that wire. She likes those. Your strawberry drops.
No wonder. They're so sweet. Mm-hmm. They smell good. Can you give guinea pig those?
You can. Sick? Yeah, that's why I got these. The people who I got these guinea pigs from gave me these.
They don't have any piggies.
They're like in this hay, this grass I just gave them. Guinea pigs aren't really as friendly as hamsters are. Yeah, just throw it in there. And they'll get it as they eat. Yeah. Well, that new guinea pig's name is Twilight. Is what the kids named her. She's really pretty. Alrighty, that's gonna be it for today, y'all. I just made some rice and some chicken for the children and my husband. And I just got off the phone with my husband a second ago. He's gonna be home late again tonight because he's working so far away. So just trying to get the chores done before the sun goes down. So thanks for watching, everybody. Y'all be blessed. Bye.